Well, we're going to get a little bit more in depth with a look at the impact of Brazil's tax policies. We welcome Paulo Sotero. He's the director of the Wilson Center's Brazil Institute. And we heard in Paulo's report that Brazil's, in terms of GDP, it's about 34% taxes. Put that in perspective. We mentioned it's not as high as the EU, but Chile, Mexico, they were right around 30%. So it's very high for Latin America.
It's higher than the tax burden of the United States. It's twice as much. The average tax burden of other Latin American countries. So 34% of GDP in Brazil is collecting in taxes. This is, and the system is very inefficient. As you mentioned, there are taxes over taxes. There is a value-added taxes that is a built-in taxes leveled by states, and they are charged at different phases of the production process. The government recognizes the problem. Recently, as the economy lost altitude, what the government did was to lower certain tax rates for certain industries, certain sectors. Lower, for instance, or exempt companies from paying certain labor taxes. Companies in Brazil have armies of lawyers and accountants following all this process.
Well, I want to talk about that because I read somewhere where it takes 108 days per year to prepare, file and pay the taxes because the system is so burdensome and so complicated. What's standing in the way of reform?
Well, political interest, because taxes are levied at states, 26 states. They have different tax rates. You have to find a formula that make the tax system neutral when you change it, so this state will not lose a revenue. You have also to compatibilize a system or make it efficient in terms of switching the burden of taxes from consumption. Taxes in Brazil are mostly on consumption. They are not on income, as in most countries, which makes it very regressive. A person making up to 10 minimum wages in Brazil pays more taxes proportionately than a person making more than that. So it's very unfair for a country that obviously wants to be and has made many inroads in social progress. But the tax system works against that.
In 2008, World Bank's Doing Business report came out, ranked Brazil at 122 among world economies in terms of ease of doing business there. We're talking about businesses. By 2013, it had slipped to 130th. What impact do you think long-term this is having on the economy? In terms of, we're looking at 2014, you got the World Cup coming, you've got the Olympic Games coming in 2016. Businesses would obviously be very interested in coming there, but you would think some of these multinational companies would say, man, it's such a headache. Does it impact the economy, do you think?
Certainly does. The companies go there because Brazil has a huge expanding middle-class market, so they will pay the price and be there. But obviously, we could become much more attractive if we would rationalize the system. There is a measure that is going to take effect in June where when you buy something, you have to see in the sales, you have to see in the bill, the receipt, what you paid in taxes. This is a first in Brazil. There is a hope that by being informed about how much you pay in taxes, people are going to start to think more about it and to mobilize politically for a change. No politician, rational politician in Brazil, supports the current tax system. They talk all the time about changing it. Well, the deal is how to do it and how to get this critical mass of political support.
We're going to have to leave it there. But thank you so much. It's very complicated. You kind of boiled it down for us. We appreciate that, Paulo. Good to see you.